Thanks for joining me today to talk about COBie4Owners. There's a lot of information available about COBie. Much of it's online, some of it's even inaccurate. So the purpose of this video is to help you cut through all that noise and get right to the important information. So let's start at the beginning. What is COBie? COBie is simply the list of all of the equipment and spaces in the building with some associated information and documents. You can think about COBie like mailing a letter. There's the contents, which is the information about the assets, and then there's the envelope. In this presentation, we'll be focusing on the contents of the COBie file and not the formats that it's delivered in. When thinking about how COBie data is developed, it's important to realize that COBie data doesn't happen all at once. COBie requirements are phased in over the life of a project. During project planning, we get the blocking and stacking of the spaces within the building. Then during design, we get information about the rooms and fixtures. And then during construction documents, we get the information about the specific details of the products that are going to be delivered, and then during construction installed. So, during planning, we can identify COBie requirements as being the sum of all of the programmed assets, which is information about room data sheets and spaces, and the equipment that's going to be placed in those rooms. As the project progresses to architectural design, we get the architectural schedules of the room finishes and the doors and windows, as well as the reflected ceiling plans and plumbing fixtures. At the construction document stage of design, we get the architectural schedules and the mechanical, electrical, and plumbing products, and any other scheduled assets. At the construction handover stage, COBie requires that all of the information about installed assets, approved submittals, installed products and equipment information be delivered. COBie does not require that any information about the geometry of the building be provided. That information is provided elsewhere. So the most important thing an owner can do when thinking about COBie is to define what job needs to be done and what data is needed to help perform that job. In the next several slides, I'll introduce some very important questions for owners who are thinking about using COBie. The first question to ask is simply, what assets do we manage at our facilities? In some cases, the answer might surprise you. The initial answer to the question is certainly the list of all the equipment that has moving parts. This equipment is under warranty, it has preventive maintenance plans, it has replacement parts, it has a preventive maintenance schedule. All of that information is COBie information. Other kinds of managed assets are not so obvious. Take, for example, the fire extinguisher that has to be inspected once every 6 months. There are other kinds of assets in the building that you really don't manage very much. The windows, the doors, the floor slabs. These are certainly facility assets, but unless they're managed and unless you maintain data about their performance, chances are you really shouldn't capture it because you're not going to have a place to put the information. Another question that owners should ask about COBie assets is, what is the level of detail needed on specific kinds of products? Sometimes that information would be commercially available, and sometimes you might be requiring people to type it in. And if that's the case, the development of COBie data can get quite expensive. So rather than shoot for the moon and make the contractor type in everything, the owner's COBie specification really needs to consider what is currently being provided in the contract and use that as the basis to gather the COBie data that can be used to meet the level of detail needed. Getting nameplate information for equipment is pretty straightforward. The nameplates are there, and the requirement to deliver the nameplate data is directly in most construction contracts. While the requirements to deliver property data for equipment is fairly straightforward based on a requirement of nameplate information, the requirement for other kinds of assets are not so clear. Here's an example of a carpet tile. And the point of this slide is to really say that one man's product, a 1 square foot carpet tile with certain properties as specified, is really another person's complete layered system of products. Anytime an owner begins to have a discussion about is it a layered set of materials or is it an individual product, there will probably be difficulties getting that information in a COBie dataset. So the last question an owner needs to address when thinking about COBie is, how am I going to retrieve the information across multiple buildings and multiple facilities? The answer to this question is classification. So take the example of this box of balls here. One might be interested in finding all the balls of a specific size, or made of a specific material, or for a specific sport, or even based on color. Any of these criteria could be used to sort the balls. These criteria are classifications. COBie has a default classification if an owner doesn't already have categories specified in their facility management database, and that default classification method is provided by the Construction Specification Institute's OmniClass. OmniClass is not a requirement of COBie, but it can be used as a suggested default if an owner doesn't have a classification scheme already in place. Here's an example specification that you can find on the Whole Building Design Guide. It covers design build and construction contracts. Let's take a look at the generic requirements that are included in this specification. The design requirements for COBie are quite straightforward. Anytime a contractor goes file print to make a set of drawings, they also need to go file save as and provide the COBie data, which is the list of all of the scheduled assets in the building. The design data should really be thought of as an outline of all of the assets in the building. It's up then to the contractor to fill in the outline with things like preventive maintenance schedules, supply and inventory requirements, replacement parts, make, model, and serial number, warranty information, and other such information. All that information is already required in their contract. They're just linking it in based on COBie submittals. Designers and contractors probably won't directly use COBie. They'll use the products and services that they have always used to do their design and construction work. Those software systems will transform the data inside their own proprietary systems into the open standard COBie format. The following two slides show an example of how that transformation takes place. In this example, we'll use the spreadsheet version of COBie since the transformation is very straightforward. Here we see a finish schedule in the upper left-hand part of this slide, and the finish schedule is composed of two parts. One is the list of spaces or rooms in the building. Those are transferred to the COBie space worksheet, and the properties of each of those spaces. And those properties are provided in the COBie attribute worksheet. In this second example, we have a fan schedule in the bottom right-hand side of the slide, and that fan schedule is decomposed into a COBie component worksheet, which lists each piece of equipment, its type and where it's located, and then the design attributes for that equipment, which are identified in the COBie attribute worksheet. Regardless of how the COBie data is delivered, the facility owner can accept that information directly into software that they use on a regular basis. Within the National Institute of Building Sciences, the Building Smart Alliance has been testing facility management software since July of 2008. Much of the software that's used for maintenance management, asset management, and integrated work order management can all be found on this list. If your product is not on this list, you should contact the Building Smart Alliance and your software vendor. I hope that this video has answered a couple of your basic questions about COBie4Owners, and I appreciate you taking the time to spend with me today.